You're going to get killed. This isn't a threat. This is an Instagram message that I got to warn me. Because last week I decided to visit the most dangerous region in the world. Central America. When it comes to labels, this area has a lot of them. Take Honduras, for example. People call this country the world's most dangerous country. The airport, the second most dangerous airport. The city, the homicide city. And because of labels, not many tourists come here. The airports are not the busiest, and the beaches are quiet. This is the label trap. We assign negative labels to other places, and these labels stick for years and decades, even when things improve. If you look at the statistics, you'll see that Honduras' crime rate, no matter how high, has been on the decline 26% in the last year, and I bet you didn't hear that in the news. The crime rate has been cut in half. This is real, tangible improvement here and around the world. Objectively, this place is not the world's most dangerous country.
How many times have you been mugged?
One in Honduras.
One?
Just one.
In how many years?
In 39 years.
In 39 years?
Yes.
In 39 years?
Yes. One here in Honduras and two in the States.
Crime does exist in Latin America. This is a fact and you must be careful here. But it's mostly gang related, not tourist related. This is why this video is important, because places like Honduras have a lot to offer beyond the labels. Take their cities for example. Just a simple 20-minute drive from the capital, you come to a place where every wall is a piece of art that makes a great Instagram. This is the Instagram capital. Like the unique food of Baleadas, like the world-class coffee export, and world-class islands. Negative labels not only hurt me and you, they hurt entire